Well, space travel used to be this futuristic thing far off into the distance, but not anymore. Did you know that SpaceX has averaged one rocket launch every 9 days on average so far in 2021? Let that sink in. And while it is, today's ETF battles is between three space exploration ETFs. So which ETF is the best way to invest in this emerging theme? Stick with us. We're going to the moon. Space travel and tourism is currently a $20 billion annual market that will double from $400 billion today to over $800 billion in the next 10 years. That's according to research from UBS. Now, space travel has also become a playground for billionaires like Jeff Bezos, Richard Branson, and Elon Musk, with each working on their own space travel program. So which ETFs are best positioned to play this innovation in the space theme? Well, today's clash is another audience-requested matchup. This one's a triple header. It's between three space ETFs. We've got ARKX, UFO, and ROKT. Now, the ARK ETF is actively managed, while the UFO and ROKT ETFs are both index-linked. So you're about to find out what our judges think about these funds. Now, just a quick reminder that if you're here for the first time, be sure to subscribe to ETF Guide TV, drop us a line. And if you've got a specific ETF battle request that you'd like to see, hit us up on our Twitter feed at ETF Guide or in the comment section below. We've also expanded the field of battle matchups to now include mutual fund tickers. So if you'd like to see a mutual fund ETF ticker, send it to us and we'll look at it. So helping us to judge today's matchup is Dave Nadig, Director of Research at ETF Trends, and Todd Rosenbluth, Director of ETF Research at CFRA. Dave and Todd, welcome back. It's great to see you guys.
Thanks for having us.
Great to be with you.
So we've got our four battle categories: cost, exposure strategy, performance, and then the mystery battle category, where you guys get to pick that one factor or maybe multiple factors that support your analysis. Our judges are going to pick their favorite ETF in each of these categories. And then at the end of the show, we'll declare an overall battle winner. Now, this is a space-focused battle, so I need to ask each of our judges what their favorite space-related movie or song is. So let's start with Todd.
Well, Dave's more the music guy than I am. And so I'm going with old school. So Spaceballs, the movie, not Spaceballs, the lunchbox, not Spaceballs, the various other things. If you've seen the movie in the last 20 years, you know the joke that's tied to it. That was my all-time favorite.
All right. That's a good one. That's on the in the comedy genre, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
What about you, Dave? What's your favorite space-related movie or song?
Well, we're going to have to go with music. And honestly, we could pick a couple from David Bowie. I would probably pick Space Odyssey, which is the song that everybody knows of, you know, this is Major Tom to ground control. Although Starman is also a good second choice there. So just stick with Bowie and you'll be fine.
Absolutely agree. 1,000%. You can't go wrong with Bowie. And so I'm going to also provide links to Dave, Todd, and Ron's space soundtrack / movies. That's going to be posted in the description section below, so you can check that out. Listen to them or watch them after today's Galactic Showdown. So let's get this battle started with the first category. Todd is going to go first to get us started, and the category is cost. So Todd, how do you see it?
This is a relatively simple one. We've got ARKX and we've got UFO that charge 75 basis points. We've got ROKT, R-O-K-T, that charges 45 basis points. ROKT is relatively illiquid. It's a pretty small ETF. It doesn't trade very much, but 45 basis points by far is the advantage we think that's out there. I think we'll talk about it a few times, but ARKX having become actively managed, you're obviously, it's grown in size. You get a lot more than you're going to get from the other ones, and you may be willing to pay that higher fee. But from a cost standpoint, ROKT is the winner to me.
That's a good start. Thank you, Todd. Dave, how do you see it in terms of cost? Who wins the battle?
Todd's got it clean here. I do think that the trading is problematic, but the honest truth is you can't overwhelm the huge difference here in expense ratio. 30 basis points is a big, big difference. You got to give it to ROKT.
Excellent. That takes us to the next category, which is exposure strategy. So Dave, who's your battle winner?
So, you know, this is a little bit of a tough one. These are quite different funds. So ROKT, R-O-K-T, is US based only. It's also based on search terms. So it goes in and looks at, you know, SEC filings and company reports to pick its fund, its stocks. And what it ends up with is something that's really loaded with aerospace and defense names. Conversely, UFO is global. So you're getting some of that international exposure. And it's about 80% pure play. That's in the methodology. They really are focused on companies that are generating the vast majority of their revenue from space exploration. So you're not necessarily going to pick up as much, say, Boeing or Northrop Grumman. You're going to end up with maybe a few smaller companies that you might not expect, that you may not have heard of, but that are really fully committed to the space arena. So I think from an exposure perspective, between the two index players, I have to give it to UFO. As far as the actively managed ARKX ETF, look, I wouldn't bet against Cathie Wood's team, but this is a very, very young fund. If you look at what it holds under the surface, it sometimes holds stocks that you might not expect, companies that are going to benefit from things like increased availability of satellite imagery to do things like logistics. That's not what we think of necessarily as a space exploration company. It's a space beneficiary. So a very different portfolio approach. Gun to my head, I'd have to pick UFO.
Thank you, Dave. Todd, give us your analysis and breakdown of exposure strategy.
Yeah, everything that Dave said, I agree with. You get a much smaller cap potential growth aspect with UFO, whereas ROKT, if you held it up next to an industrials or a broad aerospace and defense ETF, you'd see a lot of similarities. So for some people who want that more thematic approach, UFO probably makes more sense. That would be my winner, given that this is a thematic ETF conversation as opposed to an aerospace and defense approach to it. But both are good funds, but UFO would be my vote for the reasons that largely Dave touched on.
Very good. We need to move to the next category, which is performance. You're still up, Todd. So which of these ETFs really jumps out at you?
So ARKX is just too new. It's about 2 months old. I don't think that's a long enough period of time to judge it. We, in fact, don't even rate the ETF, and we're typically pretty early out of the gate in rating an ETF, in part using performance. UFO is by far the winner in this. Depending upon when people watch this, it's probably up somewhere between 2,500 or 3,000 basis points within the past year. We don't have 3-year track records on all the funds, so UFO has by far done well. It's done well, ironically, in part because ARKX came into the space and has been buying up, or people thought would buy some of the stocks that's in UFO. So I guess a hat tip to ARKX, but UFO would be my winner from a performance standpoint.
Excellent analysis. Thank you, Todd. Dave, how do you see it in terms of performance?
Yeah, I mean, Todd's, I think, right on the core numbers here. You want that pure play exposure. I think it's worth thinking about what you get here. So with that pure play, like over the last year, for instance, UFO is up 70%. ROKT is up only 53%, but over the 2-year window, UFO is up 12%, ROKT is up 27%. So what you're getting is a little bit more of a compressed exposure, as you would expect from a little bit more of a diversified industrials style portfolio in ROKT. But if what you're looking for is the juice, you're going to get it in UFO.
Excellent. And I know that those space investors are looking for the juice. So thank you both. Breaking it down in terms of performance, that takes us to the mystery battle category, where our judges get to pick that single factor, or maybe multiple factors that help us to understand their approach to ETF investing, as well as which of these funds stands out. So Dave, you're still up. Give us your mystery battle category. What is it and who wins it?
Yeah. So, you know, I actually am kind of a fan of active management for thematic ETFs like this. I think one of the worries I have about indexed approaches to very narrow themes is that this is a fast-moving business. There are IPOs, there are acquisitions, there's changes in technology. People actually invent new things, new ways to use some of the things that we do in space. So I do like the idea of having a really quality team focused on the industry, focused on the theme. So I think I would give that to ARKX as the mystery category. Although I was thinking about doing ticker because, boy, UFO is a great ticker, isn't it?
It is. It's a vanity plate ticker, no doubt. So I've got you down for ARKX for your mystery battle category. Thank you very much, Dave. Todd, what is your mystery battle category and who wins it?
So we at CFRA are rating two of these three ETFs. We rate ROKT, we rate UFO. We don't yet rate ARKX, although we probably will within the next few months. And so ROKT, R-O-K-T, has a higher rating from CFRA than UFO. It does so because it's a lower risk strategy. It's a lower risk strategy because it owns higher quality aerospace and defense companies, which you may or may not think of the same way from a space exploration standpoint. But we think ROKT or ROKT is more likely to outperform over the next 9 months. That to us is more of a future performance, in part from the risk profile. We like ROKT.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Todd. And that brings us to your overall battle winner. So Todd, you're still up. Break it down for us.
So I'm going to stick with ROKT, ROKT, narrowly edging out UFO, because one of the reasons that I didn't touch on, but Dave did, if you look back at a little bit longer term track record, the performance gap is closer than it would be in the past year. ROKT is cheaper. ROKT, to us, has the exposure that makes sense from a lower risk perspective, and we just think it's going to outperform. So it may not be, the ticker certainly is strong and makes you think of space and space exploration. When you look inside the portfolio, it may be a little bit different, but ROKT's my overall winner.
Thank you, Todd. And we bring it to Dave for your last opportunity to weigh in with your overall winner. Do you agree with Todd's analysis?
I can't disagree with the words that came out of Todd's mouth, but I got to give the overall winner here to UFO. I think if you're looking at a theme like this, you want some consistency, you want that pure play exposure, you want that opportunity to really outperform if you're right about things. And I love the ticker. I think I have to go with UFO here. And, you know, ARKX, we're going to have to wait and see how that fund does over time, see how it grows, how that portfolio really fleshes out. But at the moment, I got to give it to UFO.
So I'm a ROKT man, to use a song we didn't touch on, and Dave's just, you know, watching UFOs in the sky.
Okay. All right. He's swinging at you, Dave. But regardless, we all have a fascination with space. And according to my battle scorecard, this is going to be a split decision. And we had Todd favoring ROKT. Obviously, the higher quality names really jumped out to him. And of course, Todd's one of those few judges, I think maybe the only judge that has access to all these stars. So they rate the highest. And then Dave, of course, preferring UFO, obviously likes the ticker. But beyond that, just the more concentrated approach, the more juicy approach to investing in space exploration. And I think, guys, we've got a rematch on our hands with ARKX. We're going to have to revisit this one and check back with this space exploration battle. So great job to both of you. Thank you very much for weighing in and joining us on today's show.
Thanks, Ron.
Well, which ETF battles would you like to see in our next episode? Post your thoughts in our YouTube comment section. You can also hit us up on Twitter at ETF Guide. Be sure to hashtag ETF Battles. I'm Ron DeLegge with ETF Guide TV. Watch the battle before you invest. We'll catch you next time.